From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Beginning today, the Milestone Foundation shelter for homeless drug addicts and alcoholics in Portland will have to turn dozens of people away.
Earlier this month, a federal agency informed the state that the shelter and two others could only have 16 beds or would have to forfeit federal reimbursement funds. News 8's Dave Guthrow has more on this story from Portland.
Well, the Milestone Foundation facility here on India Street in Portland will be forced to downsize. I'm going to step out of the way right now and give you a look at that shelter here. This is all due to a federal agency's decision. Starting tomorrow, November 1st, as many as 80 homeless people, many with alcohol and drug problems, will be turned away. As earlier this month, the Centers for Medicaid and Medicare informed the state that the Milestone Foundation's facility is out of compliance. This substance abuse shelter and their operators were told they needed to reduce to only 16 beds by tomorrow, or they would forfeit all federal reimbursement funds. Now, city officials do say that they'll be opening up the Preble Street Community Center as a temporary solution, but again, they're looking for a permanent solution as soon as possible. We'll, of course, have the latest on this situation as it becomes available on our website, WMTW.com. In Portland, I'm Dave Guthrow for News 8.
A Portland podiatrist facing a charge of possessing cocaine is expected to change his plea in Cumberland County Court later today. Last November, John Perry pleaded not guilty. Earlier in the month, drug enforcement agents and police had arrested Perry. Court records say that authorities searched his property as part of bail conditions from a previous operating under the influence incident, and that's when they found the cocaine. Well, at peak, the nor'easter that hit over the weekend left more than 145,000 Mainers without power.
Central Maine Power crews have been working to restore power, and as of this morning, about 20,000 customers remain in the dark, so they're making a lot of progress. Air and rail travel also expect to get back to normal after yesterday's storm. This is a live look at the Portland Jetports website, where you can see everything is running on time. You can always check flight information from our website, WMTW.com, not just during stormy weather. Just go to our weather page and click on the travel section.
And the Amtrak Downeaster service between Portland and Boston also back to normal this morning. There is one change in the schedule today, but it is actually due to track improvement work, not weather. The northbound train that leaves from Boston at 5 in the evening will be combined with the train that leaves at 5:40. Yesterday's storm caused Amtrak to cancel two midday trains because of power outages along the Downeaster route.
I'm sure you know this, but always a good reminder, during any weather event, make sure you go to WMTW.com. There you can find the latest forecast information. You can also sign up for closing alerts and upload your pictures of the storm to the U Local section. And of course, it's Halloween. Local police departments across the country and even here in Maine offering some tips to make sure trick-or-treaters stay safe and have fun.
Yeah, some good reminders. Make sure to trick-or-treat, of course, with a grown-up. Only visit people you know or houses that are well-lit. Avoid houses that are in the dark and don't seem very inviting. Once you get home, have your parents inspect your treats before you eat them. And also a reminder for adults out driving tonight, go slow. Make sure your lights are on and be aware of the kiddos that you might see out walking the sidewalks. There's going to be a lot of them.
That's true. And look, great weather for it.
Yeah.
That's ideal. It's going to
be nice.
A good one.
Yeah. Thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. Your forecast and sports highlights coming right up.